Yeah, welcome back to C Basics for Beginners. So let's see what we discussed. Yeah, let's see what we discussed in yesterday's session. So yesterday we discussed data types, right? All of you, both of you, yes, remember?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Both of you understood when we use what kind of data type. There are many different data types. So depending, yes, on the data we store, we use different data types, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So further going from data types, so let's discuss about constants, expressions, and control structure in today's session, okay?
Okay.
Yeah. So we discussed variable, right? We can store any value in the variables and we can print it or we can process the value. So variable means it keeps varying. I mean, yeah, it can be varied. Constant means they are the variables which cannot change actually. Once you decide it, you cannot change it actually. I will show you an example, okay? Let me launch Dev C++. Yeah, how to calculate the area of the circle?
Yes, sir. Pi r square.
Yeah, I will take that simple as an example and I will show what is constant. Okay. So, hash include stdio.h int main. Okay. Let's name this as area of circle. Okay. So now tell me what I need to do. So first thing is I need to get the radius, right?
Yes.
So what data type you will use? What data type you will use? Whether you will use a float or int?
Float.
Because why we use float? We can use int also. It's not an issue, but yeah, radius can be decimal, right? So it's better we use float, okay? So now I declare const. This is new type that I'm introducing in today's session, okay? Const float pi is equal to 3.14. And then I will ask for the radius from the user. Enter the radius slash n. Yeah, you keep telling me what I have to write. I will keep writing.
Can it? Percentage D, sir. A percentage F.
Yeah, correct. It's percentage F. Because it is float.
Float. Okay. Yes.
Can F percentage F radius. And now what will be the area? It is also float, yeah, right? Float,
yes sir,
area is equal to 0.0. I will initialize. Okay, area is equal to pi into pi star
r star r
radius star radius. Okay, so now I will do printf. Let us print the area now. Percentage of slash n. Let me introduce some text. Area is equal to percentage of slash n comma area. Okay. Finally, we'll say return 0. Okay. So let us save this as area. Okay. So this is area. So now you understood what is the meaning of constant, right? Pi, yes, this, sir, is a constant, right? We are just assigning 3.14 because it's a standard constant. And we are reusing in the code actually. Wherever we need pi, we can use it as pi because it has got a value of 3.14. And it cannot be changed actually because it is a constant type.
Yes.
Okay. Let us execute this, okay? Run this. Yeah.
it started running with
I will enter 2.2 as radius. So the area is 15.197. Okay. It has printed the area. Now what I will do, so it is a constant, right? It cannot be changed, but I want to prove it. Okay. Now I will assign a new value for pi. Pi is equal to 4.5. Okay. Let us try to compile this. Okay. It fails actually. Assignment of read-only variable pi, because it is a constant.
Okay.
You can try this actually. So these are constants actually. So you understood what is a constant, right? How we can use the constant in the code. So now let's see control structure, okay?
Okay.
In our last session, we discussed, right, why we need the control structures. Do you remember?
Yeah, to simplify the program, sir.
Yeah, that is to function, actually. Functions will simplify the program, actually. So large code can be broken into small pieces or small functions, and they can be reused. Okay, they are functions, actually.
Okay.
For example, consider a scenario where in your car RPM, if it crosses 2000 RPM, it indicates a danger signal, like LED will glow. Some light will glow after you cross 2000 RPM. Okay. So in your code, you will be checking for 2000 RPM, and if it increases, you will glow a LED in the code. Okay. It means that depending on the data, we need to take some decisions sometimes. Okay. So we need control statements. In calculator program also I showed, right? In the division, if it gets divided by zero, it goes...
Yes, error will come, yes, sir.
Yeah, so to avoid those situations, we can check for those values. Okay. There are different control structures available in C. So one is if control structure. Other one is if else. And the other one is you can simply start building if else and if, simply start building like that. These statements will evaluate some condition and they will execute some piece of code depending on that condition. Okay, so consider we have to write a code where you need to take decision which number is larger out of two numbers. Okay. So I will give you two numbers, write a code to decide which one is larger. Will you be able to write? Yeah, I will give an example. So let us name this code as compare.c. Compare.c, same thing. Include stdio.h. Int main. Okay. This is the template of the code. Template means skeleton. Okay, now I will take two numbers, two integers, okay? Int A, comma B. And yeah, let us take it from the user.
Enter the value of A.
Enter two numbers. Okay, slash N. We can, yeah. So now let us take it. Scanf. Here we are percentage taking two numbers. Okay. So we have to write two percentage Ds. Percentage D, comma, address of A, comma, address of B. So the numbers will be stored in variables A and B. So I will just write if A is greater than B. Printf. Percentage D is larger. Slash N. So I am printing the value of A. Okay. I lost the WhatsApp connectivity.
Okay.
If B is greater than A, percentage T, B is larger. You are able to understand this, right? What's the induction?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. So these are simple maths, right? This is simple. In maths also, we use greater than and lesser than.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is where we can find it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, this is by using if. Okay. Now I will simplify this. Okay. Let me comment it out. I will use else. Percentage is larger, and which is B. Okay, this way also we can write. What I'm trying to tell you is, this is the format. If here the condition will come between two braces, and if the condition is true, then first piece of code will be executed, and if the condition is false, it executes the remaining part. So these are grouped under braces. Okay, this is the way. This is the format of if and if else if. You can start building anything like that. Consider there are three numbers. Okay, enter three numbers. Now there are A, B, and C. Comma, address of C.
C.
Okay. So you can add here else if A is greater than, if else if B is greater than A, B is larger. A is greater than, so this is wrong actually. A is greater than B.
B.
And A is greater than C. Right? If B is greater than A, I will tell you the use of AND actually. It's a binary logical operator. And B is greater than C. Okay. Else, if C is greater than A, and C is greater than B. So here, what we can print is, printf percentage D, C is greater. C, yeah, sorry, C percentage is greater. So you can keep building this if else, if else, if else. You can keep building it actually in a nested fashion. Okay, now you understood how to use if else and if, right? And yeah, the new operator I introduced is AND operator here. Okay, this is the condition, and the logical AND, you know, right? If this condition is true and this condition is true, if both are true, it will execute this. And if I put OR here, this is the symbol for OR. If A is greater than B, or A is greater than C. If any of this condition is true, it will execute. That is not the right choice for us. I'm going to explain the operators and expressions in the upcoming session. Okay. Then you will learn what are these operators. Okay. So understood, right? How to use the if else?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I will just save this. Let us go for one more control structure. So what we discussed is control structures. So we discussed if else. So now we will discuss switch statement. Okay, this is the last control structure. Yeah, come back to the calculator program. Okay, let us load the calculator program. Yeah, this is the calculator program. You can see the switch statement here, right? Switch, and this choice should be an integer number. So whatever the value of this one, that this case will be executed. If the value of choice is 1, this block of code will be executed under case 1. If the value of choice is 2, it executes the code under the case 2. And after execution, there is a break statement here. It will come out of the switch statement.
Switch statement.
Yeah, now you understood the format, right? I will just show you the format of switch statement. So in general, if you want to generalize the switch statement, so this is switch. Okay. This should be integer choice. And then case, depending on the value of choice, actually 1, and then break, and this keeps repeating. Okay, this is the format of switch statement. So this switch statement, you understood, right, how we used in the calculator? Because this has got multiple inputs, depending on the inputs we have to do the corresponding operation. So we had a choices here, 4 choices we had. So we used switch and choice statement here. Understood, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This is about switch statement. Yeah, let's go to loops, okay? What is a loop in general?
It repeats again and again.
Yeah. So loops means something which repeats. Okay. So some statements needs to be executed repeatedly. Okay. For example, consider you have an integer array of 10 members. Okay. How do you print the value of each value of this array, each element array, value of this array? So you can print it, right? Printf. First element. Yeah, I have to add percentage d and all. I am not adding here. Printf. Second element. Then printf. Third element. So it keeps growing, right? So you'll be printing 10 elements like this. So statements will, the number of statements will increase here. So it depends on the number of array elements we have. If we have 100 elements, we have 100. So what I'm trying to tell you is here, printf is repeating. This is the repeating code. So we can add this printf in a loop so that it gets repeatedly executed. And we can print the array elements. For example, in this case, what we can do is, there is a loop called for loop, okay? For, let us make this int I is equal to 0, okay? I is equal to 0, I less than 100, I plus plus, and here I will add printf a of I, right? I keeps varying from 0 to 100. And this is array element indexing. So each time, first time I will be 0. Because initially this is called as initial value. This is called as condition. And this is called as increment. So first I will be 0. It comes here. So I is 0, for prints 0th element. Then it increments. Then it checks the condition whether I is less than 100. Because I is less than 100, it keeps executing one more actually. You understood, right? How it is happening?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So if you want to generalize the for loop, so now we got to know how code size can be reduced, right? So loops will reduce the size of the code and it simplifies the implementation. So if you want to generalize the for loop, for, then initialization, then condition, then increment or decrement, and then within the braces write the code here which needs to be repeatedly executed.
This is the format of the
for loop. So there is one more way we can code this. We can initialize I to 100. Okay, then I should be greater than 0, then I minus minus. So it prints in a reverse way. First I will be 100, it prints 100th element, so it prints in a reverse way. You understood, right? How we can change different.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is about for loop. There is one more loop called while loop. Okay, I will explain you while loop also. While loop. Okay, the format for the while loop is while condition and then code. This is very simple. So while keyword, while is a keyword, and there is a condition. If the condition is true, it keeps executing this code. It is very simple. If the condition is true, it keeps executing the code. So how we can print the array of these elements by using while loop? Let us think yourself. So I'll do int I is equal to 0. So now while I less than 100, printf A of I, and then do we forget in something?
I.
Which one? See, it keeps printing 0th element now. So I have to increment the I. I plus plus means actually it is equal. I forgot to tell you. I plus plus is same as I is equal to I plus 1. This is same actually. So I will be incremented by 1. So it prints 100 elements. So to print it in a reverse fashion, initialize I by 100 and check for 0 and print it. Understood while loop, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, let me see whether Nitish has joined. Yeah, he has joined. I'm audible to all, right?
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes.
Sir, yes, sir.
Okay. So we discussed for loop and while loop. There is one more loop, the last loop. This is very simple. Do something while condition. Okay. Do this code and while condition. This is same as while loop actually. But in case of this while loop, if the condition is false, it will not execute even a single time. But in case of do while, this block of code will get executed and then it checks for a condition. So at a minimum, it executes once at least. And understood, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I will ask you one more question now. In the for loop, okay? Just think yourself. For I'll print some value. So I have given for initialization with nothing. There is no condition also. And there is no increment also. I'm simply printing. What does this do? Just think. See, there is no condition to break the loop, okay? It means it keeps printing infinitely. So if there is a condition, every time it checks for the condition, it breaks. Otherwise,
Yes.
It keeps pending. There is no condition. Okay. So in case of while, while true, it means the expression is always true. It keeps executing this block of the code. So it means it never breaks because this is always true. And the best example I can give is, consider I is equal to 1. And I'm checking I greater than 0 here. And I'm not modifying. Yeah. I'm not modifying I, or if you want, you add I plus plus also. It keeps incrementing. I is always greater than 0. And it keeps executing until the end. There is no break in this loop. So it is an infinite loop. I will tell you an example, okay? The best use of while loop. Okay. All of you have your TV and remote, right?
Yes.
How do you design a remote control software? For example, in case of embedded systems, I'll write a general algorithm, okay? In case of embedded system, that is a, there is no operating system in the remote control. There is a simple bare metal code which will be running on the remote control. Okay. I will write a pseudo code. Yeah, first include the headers required. Okay. And then I'll write main function. Main function is required for any application. Okay. Now I will do a while one. Okay. And now I will write functions. Read underscore button, then transmit underscore button. So you understood, right? Infinite is a, in an infinite loop, it is reading the button and it is transmitting the button to TV. Okay. So it is an infinite loop. There is a need of infinite loop in this kind of embedded systems. So it keeps executing until the battery is on. It reads the button and transmits the readed button. This is a very simple code. So in today's session, what we understood? Control structures and loops, right?
Loops.
I hope all of you are clear.
Yes, sir.
So in the control structure, we discussed if else, and if else if nested. And in loops, we discussed for loop, while loop, and do while loops. Yeah, we wrote some code as well. So what about yesterday's assignment? You had a lot of time, right? See, if you're not able to do, let me know. I will help you how you can do
okay.
it.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, try to do it today at least. Today, I will add two more assignments. Okay. Try to do today. See, if you are doing the assignments and if there is a regular feedback from your side, I'll be very happy to continue. And if there is no assignment from your side, and if I keep telling you in every session, the classes will be boring.
Okay, sir.
Okay. What about Nitish and Akshay?
Bro, yesterday's assignment was to execute only the code or what, sir?
Oh. So yesterday's assignment was to print the ranges of different data types by using the limits.h header file. Limits.h will have some standard macros. I will tell you about macros in the next session, okay? So by using that, you have to print the ranges of all the data types like float, double, and short int, long int, sine short, all these data types.
I used that include limits.h integers main, and then also used printf range of sine short. What you told was just executed that.